modifying camera settings in Stratocast. Once a camera has been created and is in the enrolled state, we can go back and modify any of the camera settings. From the integrator interface, click on the Clients button on the left, and click on the number in the Number of Devices column for that client. This will bring up a list of all cameras and NAS volumes associated with this client. To make any changes to an active camera, click on the name of the camera to bring up the camera's edit page. If the camera is connected to a volume on a NAS device, the NAS volume properties cannot be changed until the modifications to the camera properties have been completed and saved. The state of the NAS volume will be locked updating associated camera while the camera modification is in process. All the fields that were configured when the camera was added are able to be modified from here, including the name, subscription plan, and video resolution. We can also set the recording priority to try to maintain either the frame rate or the image quality, rotate the image in case the camera is mounted upside down, adjust the image quality and the keyframe interval. To see these settings, click on the Show Advanced Settings button below the frame rate field. Please note that the valid image rotation values are 0 and 180 degrees. Stratocast does not support a rotation value of 90 or 270. Once the modifications have been made to any fields, click on the Save button on the bottom. The state will change to Updating and then Enrolled when the new settings are in place. You can also choose to delete a camera from the Edit page. If the camera is in an error state, this is the only action that you can perform. If this is an enrolled camera that has been recording, the video associated with the camera will be deleted. To delete the camera, click on the Delete button on the bottom of the page and hit Continue on the confirmation pop-up. The state of the camera will change to Deleting, then to Deleting Video Files, and finally to Deleted once the camera has been removed from the system. Going back to the Client's Device List page, you will no longer see this camera listed. Please note that deleting a camera that is part of a multi-port encoder will also delete the other cameras associated with that video unit, including the recorded video that has not been exported to the vault. In November 2015, the plans were changed to provide customizable video retention periods. Use these new plans for all new subscriptions and for updating all existing subscriptions. If you change to a new plan, you cannot revert to the old plan. To change the subscription plan of a camera, first go to the Client's Devices page and click on the camera to edit it. From here we can change the video configuration settings, but we're unable to change the plan type. For cloud storage, we can change the configuration to one of the available presets, which are a combination of the resolution, frame rate, and retention period. Edge storage configuration presets also use the resolution and frame rate, but include the estimated number of gigabytes per day that will be used by the camera using the existing storage settings. We can also change the resolution used, recording priority, and the image rotation. If your camera is subscribed to an old plan and you want to subscribe to a new plan, click Upgrade and then select a plan from the list. Verify and update the video quality settings under the Video Configuration section. Click Save or navigate back to exit the page and cancel your changes. If you need to store a camera's video recordings for longer than the default of 7 days, you can change the retention period on the camera's edit page. Additional retention days beyond the default are offered at different rates depending on the plan you have. For prices, go to stratocast.com/plans. To extend the retention period for a camera, the client account must be active and the camera state must be active or enrolled. Click on a camera from the Client's Devices page to edit it, then go to the Subscription section. Next to the default retention period, click on the Extend button and enter a new value in days. If you want to revert to the default number of days, click Reset to Default Retention Period. Click Save or navigate back to exit the page and cancel your changes. If you click Save, the state field changes from Updating to Enrolled. The changes to the camera settings are saved.